Hello and welcome to this tutorial where I shall be showing you how to install Grunt. This is actually going to be a series that we're going to be going over the Grunt package, which is distributed through node.js. So basically Grunt is just an automation tool, so we can use certain packages and certain plugins from within Grunt to allow us to do things such as minify our JS files, minify our CSS files, create watches on files, so if they change we can automate them to be minified or whatever it may be. There's plenty of plugins and dependencies that we can install into Grunt to help us with our development and speed things up. So let's get started. What we're going to firstly do is we're going to install Grunt, and in later tutorials I'm going to be going over things such as SAS within Grunt. So yeah, let's firstly install Grunt. Let's create a folder. Let's name this Grunt for development and demonstration purposes. So I'm just going to quickly change to this folder, even though I'm already in there, but for demonstration purposes I wish to show you what I'm doing. So as I said, Grunt is a JavaScript task manager that helps you automate tasks. So what we're going to do now is make sure we have node.js up to date, because it runs on top of node.js, and as previously mentioned it's distributed as a package. So let's update node.js, run these as sudo npm. Mine's already up to date, but yours may not be, or it may be up to date, or you may have not installed node.js, but do quick Google for node.js if you do not have it installed for some reason. Next, what we want to do is install Grunt. You can actually, well, what we're actually going to do first is install the CLI, and the reason we've got to do this, let me just quickly get to grips with this. Basically, we do node package manager install globally Grunt CLI, and the reason we're doing this is so we can run Grunt from any system path and use it globally across our development and our system. So it's very basic. If you want to read more on the CLI, just go into gruntjs.com/getting-started. And the reason it actually allows you to install the CLI using Grunt through this way is because you can actually run multiple versions of Grunt. So the CLI does a very simple job of just running the version of Grunt that we've got stated in one of our dependency files, which would be the gruntfile.js. Wow, that was a mouthful. So let's install the Grunt CLI. It doesn't take too long, which is good. And next, here we are, so we're done with that. Next, what we actually have to do is open up a text editor, Sublime Text, or whatever IDE you may be using. We have to create our configuration files. Firstly, let's just quickly save this into Grunt as package.json. Open up our parentheses. So name this your project name. So Grunt tutorial version. Obviously, we're going with the lowest version. Dev dependencies. Again, this is the Grunt CLI to so it knows, well, the dependencies of the development process. Grunt contrib. You can just actually copy and paste this from the Grunt website. I'm just going to quickly write it out. I'll type it out even. Contrib. Node unit. I think it's 4.1. Nearly there. Grunt country. Probably should have just copied and pasted this. But here we are. We've already done it now. Go ahead and save that. Before we can actually install Grunt, we actually have to do these configuration files, or else Grunt will whinge. So now we've created the package.json, go ahead and create a new file, save, and create save this as gruntfile.js. I think you can use either uppercase or lowercase for the grunt file. I don't think it matters too much. So what I'm going to do next is quickly create a JS file for Grunt. package gruntfile.read in the JSON file where our configurations are. Basically what we're doing here is just telling Grunt to initialize a configuration file, which is this. Because again, we can use multiple versions of Grunt throughout our system. When we actually run Grunt, because we're coming to the end of this tutorial, it will whinge at us saying, look, we don't have a default implementation set in here, which is the Grunt file. And basically it's just saying we'd have a default implementation, so when Grunt is actually run, it has nothing to do. So if you put in here a default implementation of, look, each time Grunt is run, I want you to minify all my CSS files, and it would do that for you. Or you could set up a specific task, name your task within Grunt and do it specifically, or just do it each time Grunt is run. Now, if we go back into terminal and just run npm install, probably should have done that sudo, it's going to whinge, yep. Here we are, seems to be working. No description, no repository field, no README data, doesn't really matter. Come on, install. And there we go, Grunt's all hooked up. And just for demonstration purposes, I'm guessing it will give me the, you don't have anything as a default set within your grunt.js file. Well, gruntfile.js. Yep, warning, task default not found, use force to continue. Doesn't really matter, that we're not going to force the task to run when we've nothing in there, but there you go, Grunt is installed. And then in the next tutorial, I'm going to be going over some more specifically intermediate tasks, or maybe in future tutorials down the line for this particular playlist. I do want to get into SAS, minifying, uglifying, particularly JS and CSS min for minifying our CSS files, and maybe just messing around creating some plugins and downloading some plugins from the dependency manager. But yeah, that's it. If you do have any comments, or if it didn't work on your system, because I know I've watched quite a few tutorials and read up on Grunt before going over how Grunt works, and some stuff is outdated, and I guess you find that quite a lot with something that's not widely used, but Grunt is actually becoming more and more used throughout the development world. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I guess I'll see you in the next tutorial. Goodbye.